We're going to hope that you all join us in doing this. So real quick, we're going to pack this. Oh, they're still figuring some out. You got it?
You ready?
Y'all ready? Okay, let's do this.
Thank you.
We cannot come before God unless we are first honest with ourselves about who we are, about the mistakes we make, and about how well or poorly we care for others. In this spirit, let us offer our prayers to God. Please join me in the response prayer of confession in your bulletin or on screen. Awesome and compassionate God, you have loved us with unfailing, self-giving mercy, but we have not loved you.
We ask that you call us, but we do not listen. You ask us to love, but we walk away from neighbors in need, rather than our own concerns.
We condone evil, prejudice, warfare, and greed.
God of grace, as you come to us for mercy, we repent in spirit and in truth, admit our sins, and gratefully receive your forgiveness. In Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen.
Let us now silently confess our personal sins. Let us receive God's promise of grace. To all who turn from sin and sorrow, to all who turn to God in hope. This is God's word of grace. We are accepted, we are forgiven, we are loved. This gift we have from God.
Thanks be to God.
We will now sing together hymn number 488. Please stand if you are able. On the New York Impulse and also on the screen.
They come wrapped up in a bag or nice wrapping and bows, and you get gifts. Well, I'm going to talk about gifts, and I have something special for you too as my gift to you. But these are gifts that God gives us. And you know, the funny thing about that is they're not wrapped up in a nice little bag. It's not real obvious. But they're just blessings that God has given us. You know, some people are really good at something, and I say that that's God's gift to us. You know, like sometimes we have teachers in our lives, and God has gifted them with the ability to teach. And sometimes we have people that are artistic, and they can paint a beautiful painting, and we can't even begin to do a stick figure. You know, everybody has these different talents and gifts that God has given us. And we are so blessed by them. And I want to talk about a friend of mine. Her name is Mel. And she made special things to give to people. And you know, one thing about God's gift is when we're giving God's gift, we spread His light. And we also feel good about it, too. You know, have you ever done something good for somebody? And then you get that good feeling, like, I made Mom and Dad happy, so hey, you know? But I have a friend, her name is Mel. She made these candles. And they're real special, because these candles They represent hope. They represent light in dark times. We should shift these to the Lord right now. And I want some of you folks to pass those out to families out there. And here's a little saying that Melva, I should have printed it out to give to all of you, but Melva wrote this, and it says, there's no place like hope. Like a candle that provides light to get us through the dark, hope helps us through the dark times of our lives. Now, I was trying to think of a good gift to give to you folks. And I was thinking, I probably shouldn't give you a candle because you might get burned. And mom and dad probably won't like that. But I was talking to my daughter, who is a teacher, and she said, Mom, kids love glow sticks. So I'm going to give you a couple of glow sticks. I ask you probably don't break them now because it's not dark. And you can break them maybe tonight when it's dark. And you can spread God's light with these glow sticks, okay? All right. You can pass a couple out. Hopefully, and if there are some folks who are too chicken to count them, hopefully they have enough for you too. You can still come out if you want. Oh, I think the same color machine gets it up a little bit.
The one who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. The one who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Responding to God's bountiful gifts to us in Christ, we have opportunity to share out of our abundance.
At this time, if you've completed the cards, you can come right to the offering plate as well, or when you leave the building. Thank you. After dinner.
Thank you.
about God's gifts. God's gifts to us. So then, my brothers, because of God's great mercy to us, I appeal to you. Offer yourself as a living sacrifice to God, dedicated to his service and pleasing to him. This is the true worship that you should offer. Do not conform yourself to the standards of this world, but let God transform you inwardly by a complete change of your mind. Then you will be able to know the will of God, what is good and is pleasing to him and is perfect. And because of God's gracious gift to me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you should. Instead, be modest in your thinking and judge yourself according to the amount of faith that God has given you. We have many parts in the one body, and all these parts have different functions. In the same way, though we are many, we are one body in union with Christ. And we are all joined to each other as different parts of one body. So we are to use our different gifts in accordance with the grace that God has given us. If our gift is to speak God's message, we should do it according to the faith that we have. If it is to serve, we should serve. If it is to teach, we should teach. If it is to encourage others, we should do so. Whoever shares with others should do it generously. Whoever has authority should work hard. Whoever shows kindness to others should do it cheerfully. Love must be completely sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another warmly as Christian brothers and be eager to show respect for one another. Work hard and do not be lazy. Serve the Lord with a heart full of devotion and let your hope keep you joyful. Be patient in your troubles and pray at all times. Share your belongings with your needy fellow Christians and open your homes. Ask God to bless those who persecute you. Yes, ask him to bless, not curse. Be happy with these who are happy and weep with those who weep. Have the same concern for everyone. Do not be proud, but accept humble duties. Do not think of yourself as wise. If someone has done you wrong, do not repay him with a wrong. Try to do what everyone considers to be good. Do everything possible on your part to live in peace with everybody. Never take revenge, my friends, but instead let God's anger do it. For the scripture says, I will take revenge. I will pay back, says the Lord. Instead, as the scripture says, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him a drink. For by doing this, you will make him burden with shame. Do not let evil defeat you. Instead, conquer evil with good. That ends the reading. Thanks be to God. What are our spiritual gifts? You know, as long as I can remember, I've always wanted to play the guitar. I remember as a young kid watching Roy Rogers, and he would be playing his guitar and singing around the campfire. Watching him play sparked the desire in me also. My dad used to have a guitar when I was young. It was pretty battered though, and missing several strings. But I fondly remember holding it and strumming what few strings were there. Dad's guitar, though, eventually got thrown in the trash. Because my baby sister Sherry thought it was a potty chair. And she used it the only way she knew how. But with my dad's guitar gone, my desire. But when I was 10 years old, I went out and picked cherries one summer, and I earned a whopping $25. So I took that check and cashed it and went right from the bank to Western Auto, and up on the top shelf there was a guitar for $24. So I gave them my $25, and back then the tax wasn't as high, but I still walked out with only a few pennies, but I had that guitar by my side. And my parents realized that, I guess she does want to play guitar. So they found a guitar teacher for me who helped get me started. And he thought I was a bit too young as well, but I pleaded with him to teach me. And so he finally gave me. My little fingers hurt so much as I was pressing the strings, and I had blisters on my thumb from stroke. It wasn't easy, but I persevered. I continued, and I tried to play. But there was always that push and the desire and the knowing that kept me persevering through the pain. And I know now that this was a spiritual blessing for me. I've shared and used my gift of music my whole life, especially at work, where I truly feel blessed that I got paid for it, because I got paid to play the guitar. I would go into patients' rooms and I'd play for them, hopefully lifting their spirits a little higher than they were before I entered. Sometimes when I met a person for the first time, I'd try to figure out what song might resonate with them. And I would hesitate and I would wait. And then I'd listen to my thoughts. And then I'd wait for a song to pop into my head. You know, it's unbelievable how many times that song struck a chord in them. And it had a special meaning. I called that my God connection. And I knew he was using me. I remember one time playing the Tennessee Waltz for someone as he started to cry. And so I knew that there was a special meaning with that song. So after I finished, I said, "Was that a song that you and your wife felt special?" And you know, he wiped away the tears and he said, "You know, it wasn't my wife and our song," he said, "but I remember this bowling tournament." And he said, "But I couldn't get my rhythm down." And then I started humming the Tennessee Waltz, because it's a waltz, 1, 2, 3, and when you bowl, you take 3 steps, 1, 2, 3, you release. He said, "I will sing the Tennessee Waltz, 1, 2, 3, strike, 1, 2, 3, strike. He said, "I won that tournament, and I never thought of that in such a long time." So here I was thinking, I was biting the insides of my cheek, and I was thinking that it might have been a fond, sentimental memory. It was wonderful how that song resonated. So I know that God has blessed me, and he continues to bless me, and I'm so very glad to be able to use this gift. But a gift is not a gift unless you give it away. God blesses us with gifts, and he charges us to use these gifts that he's given us. You see, God has many gifts for us, as our scripture reading from Romans chapter 12 states, we have used our different gifts in accordance with the grace that God has given us. If our gift is to speak God's message, my gosh, we better get up here and speak it according to the faith that we have. If it is to serve, we should serve. If it is to teach, we should teach. If it is to encourage others, do so. Whoever shares with others should do it generously. Whoever has authority should work hard. Whoever shows kindness should do it generously and cheerfully. Love must be completely sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another warmly as Christian brothers, and be eager to show respect for one another. Work hard. And do not be lazy. Give it our best. Serve the Lord with a heart full of devotion, and let your hope keep you joyful. Be patient in your troubles. And pray all the time. Share your belongings with your needy fellow Christians, and open your homes to strangers. You know, the funny thing is, these gifts from God, like I said in the children's sermon, they don't come wrapped up like a beautiful package. They're not always obvious. These God-given natural talents. And it may have challenges in store for us. Like a 10-year-old painfully persevering as she learns to play the guitar. And as Seth mentioned in last week's sermon, God gives us a spark of an idea. And sometimes we struggle with it, like Moses did with the burning bush. We argue with God a bit, saying, I'm not worthy. Or just coming up with many excuses why we might fail. But as Seth mentioned last week, God is with us along the way, and whether we succeed or we fail at the task, He is there to support us as He passes out these gifts to us. Maybe you don't know what your gift is, but I bet your spouse, your neighbor, they can tell you. We need to recognize what these are. For those of you who don't know my dad, you might not know that he loves planes. In fact, he has a real plane in his garage. In fact, his garage is almost as big as his house. And when I was young, I remember a necklace that my dad used to wear. There was a round-shaped silver medallion with a picture of Jesus on one side. And on the back it said, Jesus is my co-pilot. Jesus is our co-pilot. He's always there. He's guiding us, supporting us. He's there. And He wants us to use and share the gifts that He's blessed us with. How do we recognize these gifts? Sometimes we don't even realize what they are. Many of you remember the story of Grandma Moses, who only started painting in her 80s. It took her a while before she realized her gift. And now there's a museum in Vermont that houses many of her famous paintings. I have a friend who lives in Newark, Beth Owens. She's a hairdresser by day and does some energy work on the side. But a few years ago, she started to help Mark out painting murals. She said, I don't really know how to paint. Because she'd never really done it before. But you know what? She discovered she had an artistic talent as well. And now she does paintings all the time. What a true blessing from God. And a really good friend of mine who resided in the nursing home, Melba Burnett, also discovered her gift at the young age of 88. And in the nursing home, we were doing crafts one time, and there was a project with clay that hardens when you bake it. It's called sculpting. Well, Melba took a liking to it, and she decided that Christmas she was going to make ornaments for her family and her friends. One of the ornaments that she perfected is a small candle. I don't know if you know this, but this candle has been up here in this pulpit for a couple of years. When last we talked about Mama and her candle. It's about the same time that she perfected this candle, Mark was starting the trailer home, and Mark Mark wanted me to bring some nursing home residents to the dedication ceremony, kind of to fill the seats. Nobody really knew what was going on in Mark's head, how he was going to transform the pile of dirt to the Trail of Hope. But it was the dedication ceremony, and, well, I asked Melba if she wanted to go, and she was always game to get out of the nursing home for an opportunity to just get out and just to change her, for the day. So she was always a good go-to person. Come on, Mama, won't you come with me? She said, sure. She had no idea what the Trail of Hope was, but Melba liked going out, so she came along. She became so excited about the project she wanted to help out. She felt that she really couldn't do that much, being in a nursing home and all, being 88 years old. What in God's earth could she do? Well, she decided that she would donate $20 to the project. Now, I don't know if any of you know this, but if you're in the nursing home, money's very tight. They are allotted $50 a month, which has to pay for the extras, like getting your hair done and toiletries. So a gift of $20 was a huge sacrifice for Melba. Mark, in turn, wanted to do something special because he knew that was a huge sacrifice. So he thought a lot about it, and he decided that he was going to buy $20 worth of seeds. Flowers. And then he would start these seeds in the spring and grow them so that the trail would have plenty of flowers that first year. They didn't have any budget to start things out, so that was some great seed money that Melba provided. Well, Mark wrote Melba thank you. And that Melba wasn't done then. That only just added more sparks to the fire. What more can I do? She said, she just wanted to do more. She saw the good in the project. She loved flowers. She loved getting out in nature and seeing God's beauty firsthand. So she got thinking, maybe I could make these candles. And I could give them to Mark. And he could use them for fundraisers. The people would give him money for these candles. That was her spark of an idea. You know, when she had some doubt, she would say, oh, people will pay for these. But you know what? There was a few times Mark got handed a few $20 bills for these candles, right, Mark?
That's right.
And so, Melba, she worked hard, day in and day out, making these candles. She had an assembly line going. She made hundreds, if not thousands, of these candles. And she gave them to people. If they came in the room and they were having a rough time, she would give them these candles. And she said, you know, God's with you. She'd give them their little Bible lesson. You know, God is with you always. In the dark times, His light shines. And I want to give you this candle so that you know that God is with you. Remember that. Remember that and share that. Well, Melba, she knew her days were numbered. That didn't stop her, though. I think she was working with more fury because she knew the assembly line would be ended soon. She died a year ago, December. She was making these right up until the end. And hopefully you have that gift to go home with. Please take it home. Put it in a place. Put it in your windowsill while you sleep. Remember, God's with us. God's our co-pilot. God will be there when we have troubles. Share your gifts. Share your blessings. Melba did. One other thing I want to say is her gift gave her a renewed from ear to ear. She lived in a nursing home. Many people come in a nursing home and they go there to die, but she came there to live. Live each day out to her fullest. And that's a gift, too, that she can give us today. Live each day in your fullest. Mel is still giving these gifts out. Another gift that Mel gave to us, she gave to me, was a poem that she wrote. One time I went into her room and she was kind of blue. And I said, hey, Mel, what's going on? You're always my cheerleader here. I come in here to get lifted up. What's going on? And she just said she was blue. You know, everybody's entitled to a blue day. She said, but you know, Beth, I wrote a poem years ago, and she handed me this folded piece of paper, and she said, every once in a while, I have to take it out and read it. She says, it gives me a good, quick kick in the butt, straighten me out, stop giving myself a pity party, and realize that I don't have to be blue, that I don't have to dwell on these words. I want to share that song with you now.
Who fill your life with love? Today we are going to recognize the gifts and the talents of many of the people who shared them with this church. God bless you all. And God bless you for sharing your gifts, for realizing what they are. How's God using you? As the Bible says, if your gift is to teach, then by gosh, get out there and teach. If it's to serve, then serve. If our gift is to be kind, then do it cheerfully. And if our gift is to share, do it generously. You get the idea. Now just go out and do it. Amen.
Picks up the collection from them. They audit. They have a session of deacons. who have stepped up to keep our church going. The sessions, Janice Bailey, Neil Clark, Michelle Tynan, Zayden Park, Darlene Wickham, and Tracy Raper. They've done a stellar job of keeping this church open and thriving. The deacons, with Lorraine Wolfer, Joanne Wittor, Bill Gibb, Diane Fox, Carrie Tynan, Les Barton, and Beth Whitbeck, they have stepped up to take care of our members who are in a rough time with funerals. We've had some big funerals. Anytime I've asked them to do anything, they're there. The worship committee has worked really hard to make sure that our services are meaningful. Jane Bailey, the chair of worship, has filled our pulpit with preachers who continue to feed our congregation spiritually. Over the past year, we've been blessed to hear messages from Reverend Fred Magley, Reverend Dr. Cynthia Healy Hummel, Seth Burgess, Beth Whitbeck, and Mark DeCracker. The choir led by Neil Clark has taken on new projects in the past year, including weekly hymn sings broadcast on Facebook, a couple of new cantatas, and lots of special music. The choir's visits with members in nursing homes to share favorite hymns, which was a joy to those hearing them as well as singing them. Neil's always looking for ways to add to our worship experience as well. She's purchased a video camera so that we can see Phil play the organ. And along with the organ committee, Camille is organizing with fundraisers to help pay for the much-needed repairs to our historic organ. We're up to what now? Camille, about 12,000 pounds. So it's going well. She's also our webmaster and our Facebook guru. She figured out a way, and I'll never know how, to put a PayPal button on our website. And there's direction on our Facebook, so you can go on to our website and make donations and designate where you want it to go. Phil Tippins, I can't say enough about. Phil plays our organ, which isn't just this, there's feet, and as somebody who can't walk and chew gum at the same time, he's a technician. He does a wonderful job. He's here every Sunday. He blesses us every single Sunday. He uses the printed music, but he plays by heart. And it's a gift given by God. The most sacred part of the service, in my opinion, is to quietly sit and listen to the organ play. I'd also like to recognize Don Wood, who is in Canada right now, hopefully on the way back, who plays the piano for us whenever we go on the road. We have several projects in the works at this time that couldn't happen without this whole team that makes this church go. The mission team held a yard sale where they raised a good sum of money for upcoming mission projects. The organ committee is working on another fundraiser, a tag sale, which we're going to be holding on October 14th. And there'll be more on that on our Facebook page. With the hot help of Father Leslie Owen, we will soon be starting a project to get our church windows back into shape and are inviting people to adopt a window in order to help cover the costs of this project. Since we aren't paying an installed pastor right now, we're using this time to do some building upkeep projects while we are able to afford it. We also continue to serve the community via the Interchurch Catholic Food Pantry and our own thrift store. Many volunteers from our church and other churches in the Lions Community of Faith staff these ministries so that we can serve the less fortunate. Over this past year, Aaron Perry, our church secretary, has taken on the responsibilities of the food pantry coordinator after Harvey retired. She's done wonderful things to carry on the mission of the food pantry and has done well to fill Harvey's shoes in that capacity. We receive food donations from the community, its churches, the Lions School District, Tops, Aldi's, Wegmans, Foodlink, and the League of Hope, Boys and Girl Scouts, and many other community businesses. We simply could not serve the needy in our community without all these generous people, groups, and businesses. At this time, I'd like us all to give a round of applause. So at this time, I would like to go to God in prayer. cloud of witnesses that has continued your work within this church and community. Fill us with your light and energy to serve you and your people with enthusiasm and humility. Help us to know that when we serve the least of us, we are serving you. Also, Lord, we lift up to you all the people facing the devastation of the hurricane. Keep them safe and be with them during and after this storm. Be with first responders and citizens who always run towards the danger to help, sometimes at great cost to them. As we sit feeling helpless, give us the comfort and confidence that you are with us and with all the people who are experiencing this terrible disaster. For it is at times like these that we see the innate goodness in our brothers and sisters. Bless all those involved in Hurricane Irma and keep them safe. And Lord, be with us now as we pray together as Jesus taught us all, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Malta's candle, but if you don't, you can hold it with your finger.
Or your cross.
This little light of mine. We're going to go out.